Hi children, this class is for standard 5 and the subject is mathematics. In this class, we are going to see chapter number 6, fractions, exercise 6.4. Topics covered in this class are types of fractions. We have already learned the types of fractions which are called as proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction. The next topic is called additional fractions with like fractions as well as unlike fractions. Let us first learn the types of fraction. The first type is called as proper fraction. When the numerator is smaller than the denominator in a fraction, then the fraction is said to be a proper fraction. For example, 2 by 5. Here, 2 is the numerator and 5 is the denominator. And 2 is less than 5. That is, the numerator is smaller than the denominator. Then, 2 by 5 is a proper fraction. Next, improper fraction. When the numerator is greater than the denominator, then the fraction is said to be improper fraction. For example, 5 by 2. Here, 5 is the numerator and 2 is the denominator. And 5 is greater than 2. That is, the numerator is greater than the denominator. Then the fraction 5 by 2 is called as improper fraction. Mixed fraction. A combination of a whole number and a proper fraction is called as mixed fraction. 1, 2 by 5. Here, 1 is the whole part and 2 by 5 is the proper fraction. Therefore, 1, 2 by 5 is a mixed fraction. Conversion of fractions. An improper fraction can be written in terms of mixed fraction. Let us see this with an example. 5 by 2. Here, 5 is the numerator and 2 is the denominator. And numerator is greater than denominator. Therefore, 5 by 2 is an improper fraction. Now, we need to convert it into an mixed fraction. So, 5 by 2 can be written as 5 divided by 2. We know that 2 twos are 4. Therefore, write 4 below 5 and write 2 in the quotient place. Now subtract 5 and 4, which gives 1. And the 2 is called as the quotient and 1 is called as the remainder and 2 is called as the divisor. To write a mixed fraction, we have a general format which is quotient remainder divided by divisor. In our example, we have 2 in the quotient place and 1 in the remainder place and 2 in the divisor place. Therefore, 2, 1 by 2 is the form of mixed fraction. So, 5 by 2 equal to 2, 1 by 2. Similarly, we can write a mixed fraction in terms of improper fraction. Let us consider the same mixed fraction. So, 2, 1 by 2 is the mixed fraction. Here, 2 is the whole part and 1 by 2 is the proper fraction. Therefore, 2, 1 by 2. Now, we need to convert it into an improper fraction. To convert it, we need to multiply the denominator with the whole part. That is, 2 twos are 4. Keep 4 in your mind and add it with the numerator. So, 4 plus 1 equal to 5. Therefore, we need to write 5 in the numerator and the denominator remains the same. Therefore, 5 by 2 is an improper fraction. Now, let us move on to the main topic, which is addition of fractions. First, let us see adding like fractions. To add like fractions, add the numerator and retain the common denominator. So we need to add only the numerator and the denominator is going to be remains the same in like fraction. Example number 1, page number 75. Add 5/8 plus 6/8. So both the fractions are having the same denominator solution. So we need to add only the numerator part. 5/8 plus 6/8 equal to 5 plus 6 divided by 8. We get 11/8. An important point to remember while writing the answer. If the answer is an improper fraction, see, the numerator is greater than the denominator. So it is in the form of improper fraction. So what we need to do? We need to convert the answer into mixed fraction. We have already known how to convert it. So we need to divide 11/8. So we know that 8 ones are 8. Therefore, we need to subtract 11 and 8, which is equal to 3. So in the quotient place, we have 1. And in the remainder place, we have 3. And in the divisor position, we have 8. Therefore, we know the format of writing the mixed fraction Q, that is quotient, remainder by divisor. So which is equal to 1/3/8. Therefore, 5 by 8 plus 6/8 equal to 1/3/8. The next topic is adding unlike fractions. Exercise 6.4, page number 79. The first question, add the following A problem 7/9 plus 2/15. Here, both the denominators are different. Therefore, both the terms are going to be unlike fraction. Solution, the first step is to find the LCM of the denominators, that is LCM of 9 and 15. We need to find the LCM. Therefore, we need to write the denominators in the format 9, 15. Both the numbers can be divisible by 3. So we get 3, 5. Again, we need to divide it by 3, which gives 1, 5. Because 5 cannot be divisible by 3, we write 5 as it is. Again, we need to divide it by 5, we get 1, 1. Now, the LCM is going to be the numbers 3 into 3 into 5. So, 3 are 9, 9 5s are 45. So, LCM equal to 45. So, LCM of 9 and 15 is 45. The next step is to convert the given fractions with the denominator 45. So, 7/9 equal to denominator should be 45. So, we need to multiply with 5. When we are multiplying the denominator with 5, we need to multiply the numerator with 5. So, 7 into 5 divided by 9 into 5, which is equal to 35 divided by 45. Let us take the second fraction, 2/15. So, 15 need to be converted into 45. So, we need to multiply the denominator by 3. When we multiply the denominator by 3, we need to multiply the numerator by 3. So, 2 into 3 by 15 into 3, which is equal to 6 divided by 45. Now, the denominator becomes same. So, it is comes under like fraction. So, we need to add 35/45 plus 6 divided by 45, which is equal to, we can add the numerator, so which is equal to 41 divided by 45. The last step is to write the question 7/9 plus 2/15 equal to 41/45. The next concept is adding mixed fraction. Let us consider exercise 6.4, page number 79, second problem. Add the following. A question, 4 11/20 plus 4 1/5. Here, both the terms or mixed fraction. Solution: the first step is to convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. So we take the first fraction 4 11 by 20. We have already know how to convert it. Multiply the denominator with the whole part, that is 20 into 4, plus we need to add the numerator, so plus 11 divided by, retain the same denominator as it is, which is equal to 20. So 4 into 20 is 80, 80 plus 11, 91, so 91 divided by 20. Let us take the second fraction, 4, 1 by 5. So we need to multiply the denominator with the whole part, so 4 into 5 plus 1 divided by 5. So 4 5s are 20, 21 plus 1, 21, so 21 divided by 5. Now let us look on to the denominators. Since the denominators are different, we need to find the LCM of the denominators 20 and 5. We know how to find the LCM 20, 5. We know both the terms can be divisible by 5. So we get the answer 4, 1. Again we need to divide it by 2. We get 2, 1. Again divided by 2, we get 1, 1. Therefore, the LCM is going to be 5 into 2 into 2. So 5 2s are 10, 10 2s are 20. So LCM is going to be 20. LCM of 20 and 5 is 20. Now we need to convert the fractions with the denominator 20. That is 91 divided by 20 and 21 divided by 5. So let us consider the first fraction, 91 divided by 20. Already we have the denominator 20, so we can multiply by 1. So 91 into 1 divided by 20 into 1, which is equal to 91 by 20. Again, take the second fraction, 21 by 5. So we need to convert the denominator to 20, we need to multiply by 4. When we multiply the denominator by 4, we need to multiply the numerator by 4. Therefore, 21 into 4 by 5 into 4, which is equal to 84 by 20. Now, both the fractions become like fraction. Therefore, we can add 91 by 20 plus 84 by 20, which is equal to 175 divided by 20. See, the numerator is bigger than the denominator. Therefore, this is going to be an improper fraction. So we need to convert this into mixed fraction, which is equal to 8, 15 by 20. Again, look at this. The numerator and the denominator can be divided by 5. So 5 3s are 15 and 5 4s are 20. So which is equal to 8, 3 by 4. Therefore, we need to write the question 4, 11 by 20 plus 4, 1 by 5 equal to 8, 3 by 4. The next topic is adding a whole number with a mixed fraction. Exercise 6.4, page number 79. Second question, add the following E problem 7 plus 2, 3 by 5. Solution, see, the first term in addition is an whole number and the second term in addition is a mixed fraction. In this format, we can add the whole part with the whole part of the mixed fraction. That is, we can add directly 7 plus 2, which is equal to 9. We can write this proper fraction as it is. Therefore, we get the answer 9, 3 by 5. Let us see one more exercise problem in the same format. See, we have the whole part here and we have whole part with a proper fraction. Therefore, solution, we can add directly the whole part with the whole part. So 11 plus 4, which is equal to 15. Therefore, 15, 8 by 9. So the answer is 15, 8 by 9. Thank you, children.